Hello, everybody! Welcome back to the Wattpad Book Club. My name is Phoenix, and once again, I am joined with one of my lovely co-hosts on this crazy adventure that we call life, my good old friend Joline.
Hello!
Aren't you excited to be back?
I am very excited.
So, you may be wondering, well, you probably tell by the title and the thumbnail that, like, something's off in the universe right now. Our canon event is happening.
This better not be our canon event, God, please.
Anyway, so we pulled up the fanfiction that we were going to read, and then we went into the author's thing to see what other things they've written, just out of curiosity, and we found their thing called Crappy Stories, and we looked through it, and two of the ships were Trump X Biden, and we started laughing and dying reading their thing, and they were like, well, how popular is this thing? So we looked it up on Wattpad, and there is a
there is a significant amount.
Oh, it's so fucking funny. There's a lot of people are shipped with Trump, apparently. A lot of fictional characters, you know, according to the text.
Greg, Bakugo, Bob the Builder, Dora the Explorer.
Dr. Phil, Obama. Some guy named Gary.
I don't know who Gary is.
We ain't talking about the snail. So,
thank God.
Yeah, thank God. So, we thought it would be a little bit of a misadventure on this one. If we take a little bit of a detour, don't worry. Next time I bring Joline on here, we will read the arcane thing. But we thought this would be really fucking funny. We fell down this rabbit hole and we can't get out. And the only way to get out is to read fanfiction. So that's what we're doing right now. So we found this fanfiction called My Little Cheeto. Trump X Biden. And what is enemies to lovers?
What did we have on that tier list? Enemies to lovers A tier? B tier?
I think it was A or B. Because I feel like did we put it on S?
I don't think so.
I think A was a good one for it, so hopefully this lives up to our expectations of this trope. And in the words of the description of the author, a forbidden romance blossoms between two unlikely men. Their passion for politics was one thing, but their passion for each other was another. Can this love affair last, or will the pressures of those around them break their special bond? And the... I love that, like, the first chapter, when you press read, is Obamacare.
Obamacare?
Obamacare.
Ah, do we have a special coin to flip?
I do! Sorry. I got, like, you know how you put videos on top of, like, Wattpad stuff? Mm-hmm. On your chapters. I got like a thing for The Guardian, and it's a debate between Donald Trump and Biden. I kind of want to pause to see if it was like a funny haha meme or if it's just a political thing.
It might just be a political thing.
Hold on, I'm gonna pause real quick. I want to see real quick. Alright, so it was just a political thing. Alright, so it was just a clip from it, so. I thought it was gonna be a funny haha meme.
Hold up.
While you are holding, I'm also holding this coin. Okay. The beautiful coin. God.
Oh yes, the coin. I'm well
shiny. 2022. It's got this woman on the back with her arms spread with an eagle. All right. Heads or tails?
Tails.
Oh right. It's tails.
Alrighty. Obamacare. The prologue. They stared passionately at one another. Who knew they would get this far? It was supposed to just be a fling, but it had turned into so much more. Something that was so amazing yet indescribable at the same time. How long had it been? Only a few months? It felt like forever, and that was enough. They had all the time in the world, and that would be enough.
Why are there 253 comments on this one paragraph?
Oh God, what is it?
I want to see. Inhale, exhale. Why am I here? What has life come to?
This is my comfort ship. Ooh, woo.
For those weirdos who like this stuff, here's a whole list. Oh my God. Is this a whole list of Donald Trump shit? Donald Trump beats Biden? Wait, hold on. I'm copying
this. I'm just scared. I want to click it.
Bro, it's a whole thing of cursed ships. So you have
what do you
one,
mean?
You have
oh
one,
my
one,
god!
It's extract. I cannot.
Egg X Reader? Egg X Reader?
Yeah.
Devin X Wall? Shrek downed his dick. Peppa Pig X Shrek?
Wait a minute.
Kool-Aid Man X Gordon Ramsay?
Numbers X Alpha.
Kool-Aid Man and Gordon do the rot to do the naughty.
The Teletubby Thick.
Mafia Elmo X Reader.
Oh my god, it's so.
No, we have Donnie to read that. Mafia Elmo.
We'll add it to the wheel. This is our holy grail. We can just pick one of these things. Shrek X Squidward. Gru X Clay Among Us.
Duolingo Smut.
Wait a minute, what the fuck do you. Oh, I see it, my dear Duolingo. I'm not like other girls. Old Man X Barney. Garlic Bread
X Reader.
This is for all my asexuals out there. Garlic Bread X Reader. This is for you, Queen. Among Us Smut is a picture of Pitbull on it.
Give me your Krabby Patty. Squidward X SpongeBob fanfic.
I gotta share that one with Minho. He'll like that one.
No. God.
McDonald's X Burger King, and it's a picture of Sans saying nice cockner. God, this is funny. Why? Oh my god.
Wait.
Thanos was caked up. Why is there
oh my god.
Danny DeVito?
Table X Reader.
Shrek X Dora.
Water X Reader.
Table X Reader. This is the fanfiction.
In which water?
Oh my god, water. Oh my god.
Whoa. Look at the table X Reader. YN, after attempting suicide, found a soothing table. But what happens when feelings blossom between the two?
Sexy microwave, Sam. These microwaves fall. Shrek X Barry B. Benson. Shrek X Obama. Shrek X Bread. God, this is great. There's chairs. There's just a picture of chairs.
There's chairs. Dr. Phil X Thomas the Train Smut and Fluff.
50 Shades of Bread.
Where is 50 Shades of Bread?
It's in between Helmo
oh my God.
And Forbidden Love, Dr. Phil Lovequest. There's Karen X Reader, and it's just a fucking picture of a fucking ketchup pile, and the description just reads, I guess she took the kids, huh? Forbidden.
The Hybrid Demon Prince. It says, read this or die, and I was like, what even?
And everyone said, what is it? Quackity X Obama Y. Oh, I found the Dr. Phyllis Thomas the Train. These are some fucking crack ships if I've ever fucking seen them. Alright.
Anyway.
I can't wait that there's gonna be fucking peaceful ass music in the background while we read this and like go absolutely insane and be like, oh my god, it's fucking 50 Shades of Bread, and the music be like, doo doo doo.
I cannot. When we get to those, God forbid.
Yeah.
But when we get to those, I'm gonna need like, and I'm gonna need some. Help. I'm gonna need to go to therapy after.
I feel like for these, like, I feel like when we read this fucking, well, continue reading this fucking Trump X Biden, I'm gonna have to like, get up and like walk away and be like, reflect on my own reflection.
Will you ask yourself the question?
Of what the right direction is to go, because clearly I do not know. Biden looked at Trump. I know you didn't mean any of that, right? Yeah, but it still hurt. Trump mumbled curiously. Hey, Biden huffed while taking Trump's face in his hands. I would never hurt you. Trump gazed at him fondly. Never in his life had he expected someone to understand him so well. To know just the right way to say he loved this man so much with his whole being. I know, Trump sighed. I just don't expect you to call me Abe in front of everyone. I mean, you know that's only for those special times. Wink, side eye, smirk. Biden gulped. It just slipped, but he had seen the effect of his words took the man. Oh, I guess that's why the political thing was this is
Abe Lincoln. Oh God, no!
It's all related.
That's terrible.
It all comes full circle. I'm sorry, he mumbled. Trump gazed into those shattering blue eyes. Oh, how he loved them. He left a quick peck on Biden's mouth, knowing more could lead them into more unexplainable things. See you later, Trump sighed. See you later, Biden huffed, not daring to break eye contact. Love you. Love you too. Why are we here? What happened?
Anyway, wind turbines cause cancer.
I need to see that fucking political debate.
It was the spring of 2020. Trump had just had a very intense meeting, and he needed a break. I deserve a coffee, the man thought to himself. But I don't want to deal with more pesky bodyguards, he continued. Well, what do you know? A little ways away, someone had the same idea. That someone just so happened to be Joe Biden, of course. Talk about plot convenience, am I right, ladies and gentlemen? Coming upon the nearest coffee shop, Trump stood outside, contemplating his order. A black coffee with a hint of sugar, he mumbled his thoughts out loud. I'll have a black coffee with a tiny amount of sugar, please, he said in a vaguely familiar voice. Trump giggled to himself, thinking how odd the person in front of him was getting his exact same order. His eyes trailed the man in front of him, well-fitting suit matching his silver, almost white hair. I can get behind that, Trump thought to himself. His eyes followed the man until it was time to order. Awoken from his trance by the cashier, Trump began to proceed with his order. But in the waiting process for his coffee, he couldn't get the man out of his head. I can't believe I saw him there, Biden complained to no one in particular. Who? One of his advisors questioned earnestly. No one. Biden mumbled, not wanting to continue the subject. What had it been? For years he had met the man. Trump wasn't easy to forget. Biden could remember when he first had seen the man. A content smile had covered his face when they first made eye contact. But it had crumpled when he realized the man's true intentions. He was attractive, yes, but that didn't hide the disgust Biden felt for this man. Never in my life will I even get close to liking him, he promised himself.
Well, Joe Biden, I don't have that good news for you, man, but I think that's gonna happen.
Oh.
Get in, America, we're going voting. What's that fucking... Is it from fucking Mean Girls where he's like, get in, loser, we're going shopping?
I think so.
Yeah. Jesus. I gotta act serious. This is a very serious fanfiction.
Very serious. Despite the author's note being a joke.
Yeah. Yeah, who wouldn't take the title My Little Cheeto seriously?
Obviously not me. Very serious.
Time had passed ever so slowly in Trump's life. The days became a blur, and the only thing keeping him focused being a certain someone. He couldn't get that certain person out of his head, and it was irritating him to no end. He had tried and failed to contact the man, which was only furthering his rage. It was like Joe was avoiding him. Trump trotted around the office, contemplating how he would ever see the man again. Call him? No, that plan already failed once. find him, quote unquote, once again in the local coffee shop? No, because there was definitely no way to know if Vida would come back. I got it. There's a bait coming up. He's got to talk to me then, Trump explained, as while coming to a halt in front of his desk. It's perfect. We may not be able to talk during the debate, but we sure as hell can talk afterwards. Maybe then I can tell him I want to get to know him better. With that, Trump began to practice his speech, the one that didn't relate to the debate, of course. But what Trump didn't know was that hidden beneath a door, someone stood recording every single word. Blackmail. It was Obama the whole time. He was listening in through the walls.
Oh my god, he's in the walls. He's in the fucking walls.
I can't believe I have to debate that orange asshole, Biden proclaimed, before banging his hand on his desk. His speech was finished, and now he was counting days, waiting, begging for it to be over with. I mean, you only have to talk to him during the debate. You can leave right after, a nearby assistant explained. Yep, that's the plan, Biden mumbled, but in the back of his head, he wondered if he really meant it. And so, one by one, the days passed. Each day, Trump thought more fondly of Biden, reminiscing on that one day in the coffee shop. Each day, Biden thought more of the debate. And with that came the thoughts of Trump. They were normal at first. Of course. I wonder what his points are. I wonder if he even prepared. And then, it veered a little off course. I wonder what he's thinking about. I wonder if he's thinking about me. And once again, Biden blamed it on debate jitters. But we all know it wasn't debate jitters. He was having a man crush. And then the day came. In more ways than one, millions of Americans tuned into the news. They were interested in how the two men would argue, but the men were interested in something else. Will he finally talk to me? And so the debate began. I'm writing this while waiting for Nevada to hurry the fuck up. Oh! They were actively writing this when the fucking, like, when the fucking votes are coming in?
That is an amazing way to pass the time.
Yeah, two candidates. Didn't people call that election, like, the path to change history or whatnot, or some stupid, like, something like that?
And I don't know.
The thing is happening. You're just sitting there writing fanfiction between the two.
You know what? When the next crisis that comes along, whether that be pandemic or concern of, I don't know, World War III, we should write a fanfiction about some political leaders.
Yeah. That's how we pass the time. Also, we're gonna be rich.
That's how we'll cope before they start drafting us.
Yeah. We gotta leave a record behind of what our thoughts were before we get drafted and shot.
It'll be the last thing they see of us.
Yeah, my last ever documentation is a fanfiction.
Oh god, no! September 29th, 2020. It was finally September 29th, 2020. Both candidates had prepared, well, as much as they thought they needed to. I'm Chris Wallace of Fox News, and I welcome to you to the first 2020 presidential debate between President Donald J. Trump and former Vice President Joe Biden. This debate is sponsored by the Commission of on Presidential Debates. The commission has been designed to the format roughly 15-minute segments with 2-minute answers from each candidate to the first question, then open discussion for the rest of each segment. Trump nervously twitched. He was finally here. Joe was barely a room away from him. Breathe. You just have to do this for 1 hour, and then you can finally tell Joe how you feel. Easy enough. As a precaution, both campaigns have agreed that the candidates will not shake hands at the beginning of tonight's debate. What? Trump explained a little too loudly. It's just for precautions. No need to fret. You don't want to touch that jerk's hand anyway, a nearby associate mumbled nervously. But the thing is, I do. No matter how much contact I have with Joe, I want it. Trump thought with disappointment. Oh, but he does. Melania mumbled under mumbled under her breath, just soft enough for no one to hear her. And with that, the two of whom it entered the stage. He looks good in that suit, Trump thought nonchalantly. God damn it. Why won't he stop interrupting me? Joe thought while glaring daggers into Donald. Oh my god, he's looking at me. Trump quietly adjusted his suit. Now, gentlemen, your opinions on the nomination of Amy Coney Barrett for Supreme Court, Wallace questioned. Well, simply put it, it shouldn't have happened. For one, well, you see, Joe, Trump stated. Desperative, Biden focused on him once more. Gentlemen, please. It's not yet an open floor. I'm trying to debate Joe here, not you, Wallace. Trump grumbled, trying to hide his agitation. It was 20 minutes in. Neither candidate had actually answered any questions so far. Damn. Tired of Trump, Biden proclaimed, the fact is, everything he's saying here so far is a lie. I'm not here to call out his lie. Everyone knows he's a liar. Trump stood stock still. Had Joe just said that? The man he put on a pedestal had completely bashed him in front of America? He knew it was a debate, but still, he couldn't help but feel a little piece of his heart shatter. Biden noticed the sudden change in his opponent and didn't point it out. Had he done something wrong? I mean, they were debating after all. But a small part of him wanted to run across the stage and help him out. What was that feeling? It was strange. Oh well, better to push it all down. But Trump was upset, so Trump did the only thing he knew how to do. He brought up topics unrelated to the discussion. Don't lecture me about the military. When your son was dishonorably discharged, not only that, he couldn't get a job anywhere because of his drug addiction.
Oh my god.
What do you have to say about that, Joe? Trump rebutted, desperate at this point.
Jesus, and this so, sounds like a soap opera of like, this is what two catty women throw at one another.
Oh my gosh.
You know what I mean, right?
Like, yeah.
It's giving off that fucking one vine. It was like, that's why your shoes raggedy. That's why your mom and dad dead as hell.
Where are shoes at?
What shoes she got on? What shoes she got on her casket? God damn it.
The debate continued. Both candidates at each other's throats. Neither willing to concede, the moderator trying to control the situation. Maybe someone was turned on by the situation. Who knows? Finally, thinking he had the upper hand, Biden retaliated, saying, he's Putin's puppy. Oh my god, it's like his presidential puppy instead of like Discord kitten. Trump didn't know how to respond to that. Out of all things, he had to bring my ex into things? Seriously? It was a long time ago anyway. How did he even know I was into that kind of roleplay? He couldn't know. Unless.
Wait a minute. It's canon in this universe that Putin and Trump were a thing? Oh my god. This is the best book ever.
Best book ever. Your words, not mine. Eventually, after much more arguing, the debate was over. Both parties were left unsatisfied, and all of America was left confused. What was that weird homoerotic tension they had just witnessed? Is it just me, or is it kind of hot in here? Wallace questioned. Oh, it wasn't just you, the person next to him mumbled. I think everyone noticed. There's definitely something going on here. Overhearing their conversation, Melania smiled to herself. You're right. Okay, let me read the author's note. Okay, I literally rewatched the hour and a half long debate and took notes on it for crucial plot points. I didn't include as much as I wanted to, though. Also, almost all of these quotes are directly from the text. Again, this took me forever, and I low-key hate it. Side note, I really want to write a serious fic, though. I intend to see this one through to the end. So whenever I finish this one...
Oh my god. They took the polymer, sir. I gotta read this person's other stuff when we're done. Thank you, Kanye. Very cool. Wait, is this referring to when Kanye came to the White House and he was, like, showing Trump's shit on the phone?
I don't know.
Didn't Kanye come to the White House? He was like,
dude, I don't remember anything of 2020.
I think this is where the phrase comes from of thank you, Kanye, very cool. I'm gonna have to look at the meme later and figure out, but I'm pretty sure that's where it comes from. Finally, the debate was over. Trump rushed towards the back room, ignoring his associates, briskly following him behind. And there he was, standing as handsome as ever. Trump knew it was now or never. Biden, he said, trying to maintain some of the confidence as possible. Trump, the debate's over. I don't want a worse headache. Joe responded curtly, but Trump wouldn't back down. It's important. I need to talk to you one-on-one. Trump stated desperately.
It was like JFK. The cadence he used to that reminded me of JFK from Clone Hines. And I'm just like, what?
I was trying to remember, like, how the fuck does Trump sound? It's been a while since I've seen him. And he's like, it's like that kind of like shitty voice. I was trying to imitate it.
I just thought about JFK.
Shit. Trump saw the hesitance in Biden's face. What made it worse was the clenched grip Jill maintained on Joe's arms. It made him sick. That should be me. Oh yeah, I forgot. They're married. Womp womp.
Womp womp.
Fine. Jill, wait here. And with that, the two went towards the room. To the room next door for a private conversation. They were alone. Finally. Joe, I have to get something off my chest. Chubb gulped. Well, hurry up, I don't have all day. Agitation in his voice. I like you a lot. I did it. I finally did it. I've been waiting for this for so long. It feels so good to finally get it off my chest. What? Heavy, murderous silence filled the room. Why would you just confess to me like that? What the hell? And you think I feel the same way? You're sick. You're my competitor. My rival. You really think it would be deemed acceptable for us to even think about being together? I'm only trying to do what's best for us, Trump cried, his heart already beginning to crack. Us? There is no us. There will never be an us. You're deranged. I never asked for this. I never wanted this. Looking in your eyes, I feel like I'm at home. Trump reached out to Joe, desperately trying to show the man that it wasn't a cruel Joe, that he really felt this way. Just get away from me. Just please stop touching me, Joe explained, sick of the situation. I know who you really are. I've always tried to be someone else, but with you, I realize I'm not alone. I'm trying my best. He needed Joe to understand his feelings. He needed an ounce of hope that Joe felt the same way. He couldn't take much more. Well, you're only scared of me, Biden said, trying to prove that Trump's feelings were misinterpreted. I like you, even though you've never cared for me. His feelings had come out of nowhere, but they still existed. He couldn't push them down, even if he tried. Why won't you let me be free? I have a wife and kids. I'm happy here, Joe mumbled. It was all true, but could it be that he was trying to prove to himself rather than Trump why he couldn't return the feelings? Well, you'll never dare to be in a relationship with me. Trump knew the result of this confession. His confidence was disappearing, and he felt numb. Well, you're never listening. You're always insisting. I'm just reminiscing. Though little Trump still cherished those memories. Well, stop reminiscing. Without you, I feel something missing. I just want you here with me. God, can't we just get along? God, won't you leave me alone? And with that, the conversation ended. both stood there, emotionless. Both didn't know how to interpret their feelings. Trump was shattered. He was numb. He was done. He headed out of the room. Biden was confused. That's a sentence, just like... He had only told the truth, but in the pit of his stomach, there was an emptiness. Something he couldn't explain, but he couldn't feel remorse or anything he had said. They were rivals, after all. The night, the two men went their separate ways. Two men with totally different views of the world. Two men who seemed to hate each other. Two men who so desperately wanted to share the same heart, even if they didn't know it yet. This chapter is sponsored by Carnona.
I'm never gonna be able to listen to Evelyn the same way again.
Wait a minute. I said we want to end the suffering with this book ASAP. I wanted to add a smut chapter, but my smut writer is too appalled by the situation, so you are very welcome. Yippee!
What? Oh god.
Get these ads out of here. I'm trying to read Donald Trump x Joe Biden.
It had been one night, a long and strenuous night, both parties contemplating the conversation prior. Trump stared up at the ceiling above. He lay in bed, repeatedly outlining everything he'd said, desperately trying to find out where he went wrong. He felt ill. Maybe it was the fight, but perhaps it was something else. Biden stared into the darkness that was his office. He wasn't going to bed anytime soon. He stared at his hands, his old, calloused hands. Those same hands were responsible for causing so much pain, and today, they had caused even more. Joe ran a hand through his thinning hair. What a day. What a night, even. And Joe started writing. He wrote through the night. He wrote about his thoughts. He wrote about his feelings. He wrote about how much he loathed himself and how he could never see anyone being happy with him. He wrote about how Trump made him feel. He wrote about how perplexing it was to be a 78-year-old man just trying to figure out their sexuality. He let all his feelings out, no matter how confusing they may be. And then he burned them. He burned every single thought. He erased them. No one would know. No one could know. They slowly drifted into a taunting sleep, one full of crushing realities and hurt and love. But the love was that... I'm sorry. But the love was what really stuck. The love he remembered.
And he was running like he was running out of time.
The next morning, Biden turned on the television. After the night before, he really needed a cup of coffee. He fumbled into the kitchen. Empty. Good. Joe began getting out his wig-a-mat. Ever since the day Trump walked into that coffee shop, Biden had started making his own coffee. He told himself that was to never run into Trump again, but it could have been the hope to make the man of his dreams a handmade coffee on a cold-fall evening. Desperate for something to wake him up while he waited for his coffee to filter, Joe turned on the television. The blue light from the screen seemed to do the trick. Half awake, he watched the anchor. After last night's event, both parties... Mike's muted. Trump tested positive for coronavirus. What? Joe heard the spoon that he was holding clatter to the floor. What had the news anchor just said? He scrambled around, desperately looking for a remote. He rewinded it, not taking his eyes off the screen. And there it was. President Trump and First Lady Melania Trump have tested positive for COVID-19. Biden felt his gut drop. He knew Trump had health problems. He couldn't imagine what would happen if he... No, you shouldn't be thinking that. He's your competitor, but... Joe picked up his spoon off the floor. He looked at it. A distorted reflection stood before him. That's exactly what I look like. I'm flawed. I'm horrible. Why would anyone love me? Why would he love me? And he stood there, going over everything he said. Exactly like last night. But this time, it was desperate. It was pleading for some reason not to love this man. Pleading for an excuse. Any excuse. But that's when he knew it. That's when he'd run out of excuses. Knew he had fallen so desperately in love. He knew he may never see this man again.
Womp womp. You know what? A lot of things have happened so far in 2024 so far. And I didn't think reading a Joe Biden and ex-Trump would be on top of the list, but you know what? Life is full of surprises.
Sure is.
Yep. This is our Canada event. This is where everything goes south.
No, please. We already had 2016.
Yay. For whom the bells toll. Trump stared defeated at the
linoleum.
Oh, what the fuck is a linoleum?
Linoleum is... I don't know how to describe it.
Is it like the popcorn ceilings?
No.
Oh.
Linoleum is like a... Hold up. Let me make sure I got this right.
Probably like those flat-looking ones. I don't know. It probably has like granite. It's probably fucking made out of
granite. Normally, I thought linoleum was flooring, but like, I guess it could be ceiling in this situation.
Some people put like, make cool little things with the wood and put it on the ceiling.
Yeah, let's just go with that.
Yeah. Alright, cool. He looked at the wood at the ceiling. The flecks of green on the top of the polished white tile seemed to fade in and out of his vision as his vision worsened. How had it come to this point? A man, frail, heartbroken, and totally alone. He had family, yet he was still utterly alone. There was one man who made him feel at peace, though. Joe Mama. But those feelings deserved to die. Trump had put his heart on his sleeve and suffered the consequences. He could no longer appreciate the simple things in life. A simple smile Joe used when he knew he had the upper hand. The way Joe always talked about his hands, talked with his hands whenever he got passionate about a topic. And of course, his kindness towards others. Trump admired that thing he could never obtain. But Trump swore he would not be dealt the same fate. So, as he sat, lonely, in that cold hospital room, Trump flexed his hands into a fist, whispering the same phrase over and over again. I do not love you, Joe. I cannot love you. And that seemed to do the trick as he floated into a fistful sleep. Joe grabbed his coat in a rush and headed towards the door, ignoring the wandering, worried glances. He tore open the door into the brisk autumn night. He no longer could care about what others thought. He decided that when he realized his true feelings, his feelings towards Trump, his little Cheeto, and that burning desire to see the man he loved only pushed Joe forward towards the hospital. Already seeing the car surrounding the building, Joe knew it would be nearly impossible to get in. Trump was the president, of course. Quickly looking around, Joe spotted an unguarded door. However uncommon, Joe couldn't lose the opportunity. Just as he was about to open the door, he felt an arm on his shoulder. Excuse me, sir, but this is for authorized personnel only. Please return to your residence. He said a faint voice behind him. Oh, I'm so sorry, but I need to get into this hospital. Joe stared at the man, trying his best to keep a poker face. Politics taught you anything, is that with enough confidence anyone could believe anything? Oh my god, I mean, this is facts. that is straight up facts about anything. So sorry.
I thought they were gonna stop him. Like, he was just gonna sneak in through that door. I'm just like, wow. They would have really let him get assassinated.
Also, like, I feel like you would recognize, one of the top candidates and whatnot before you, grabbed him by the shoulder and turned him around and whatnot.
This is like a frail old man.
Yeah, he's just a guy. You can grab him by the shoulder a little too rough and it would break.
Yeah, swims. He's made of twigs.
He's got glass bones and paper skin. Every afternoon he breaks his legs, and in the morning he breaks his arms.
Oh gosh, a gentle gust of wind is gonna knock him down.
Yeah, he's gonna fall over. So sorry, Mr. Vice President, sir, right this way, please. Joe huffed a sigh of relief as the security guard turned his back. He wasn't being escorted off the property, but instead being welcomed. Still, Joe preferred the inconspicuous route. Gliding through the sliding doors, Biden made his way towards the side stairs. There were multiple security officers stationed around, but that meant fewer people in the stairway, perfect for an incognito approach. So he slipped through the stairwell and started his climb. He double-checked the steps every so often, doubling back if any strange whispers seemed to be close by. Finally, he got to the sixth floor. Nerves whacked, raking up and down. And at that moment, he realized something catastrophic for his whole plan. I fucking don't know what floor he's on. Joe facepalmed. His plan had been smooth sailing so far, but of course there was going to be some kind of kink in the way. Nervously, he peeked his hands out. Seeing no one in sight, he closed the door cautiously of everything around him. The crooked door, the way his shoes squeaked when he walked, the way he breathed seemed to be getting heavier the further he walked, and then, all of a sudden, he saw it, no one guarding it, and not a stream of doctors in sight. A room with one name on top. Trump. This thing, they got, like, those printed papers and whatnot.
Mm-hmm.
They get for printers, they just, like, wrote it with, like, Sharpie, and just put it on top of the door.
Yeah, just... Not even, like, an actual paper. It's actually just a napkin.
Yeah. The one does, like, the thumbtacks in the wall. Praying to absolutely anyone up there that he was in the right room, he tentatively opened the door, and there he was, sleeping peacefully. But Joe could see that he was hurting. See the pain and sickness that was slowly taking over his body. And that shattered Biden's soul. This man... who had learned to cherish was in so much hurt, and he couldn't do anything. He approached the bed somberly. He looked over Trump, and the tears began to form. He gripped harder on the dingy plastic hospital bed, trying to find something to hold on to. Something to keep him standing as waves of hurt kept coming.
Hold up.
Yeah?
So he's just breaking into this area. This is like 2020, where like COVID's hella, you know... hella rampant, yeah. And he's just no mask, nothing.
Yeah. Yo, what's wrong? This is so accurate.
It is very accurate. I was in that hospital when Trump was there.
Oh my god,
did you
really?
Know that?
Oh, you really?
Yeah. Yeah, I was. I cracked my bones in half, all of them.
Oh, you have glass bones?
And paper skin.
You like fell down the stairs that morning, and then like your mom comes by and it's like the fucking Peter Griffin pose on your
Yeah, that's exactly right. Were you there?
Yeah, oh yeah.
Oh my
yeah,
god, did you visit me? Oh yeah, I think you visited me in the hospital.
Yeah, I watched you fall down the stairs.
Oh my god, no. But did you record it?
Oh yeah, absolutely.
Oh my god, you should have posted it for content.
Frank is absolutely the murdered by stairs. Hashtag Zora moment.
Hashtag get own loser.
What's that girl's name from One Piece that died from falling down the stairs? You just did that.
No, you're survived. Alone.
But you survived, so that
hashtag
makes you better.
Just like Queena.
Queena moment.
No!
So he stood there, stifling his tears, afraid to wake the man, and he began to talk. He talked about his feelings, opened up truly. He whispered about how much he loved Trump and how much he regretted that fateful day. How he wished he could take it back in time and embrace the fact that Trump was so willing to love him, to cherish him. I love you, Trump. I always have. And I know you will never forgive me, but I want you to know the truth. Then Biden got up and turned away. His work was done. It was time to face the consequences. And then, as he began to descend back down, that dissolves...
Desolate
the hallway, he heard an ever so faint cough. Joe. He stopped in his tracks. There he was, the man of his dreams, dressed in a thin hospital gown, shivering. He looked, too, like he was on the verge of tears. Donald. Joe replied, not knowing what to say. He was rendered speechless. Had Trump heard everything? Was he here to make things right? Trump began to grip the wall, steadily moving towards Joe. It seemed like he was desperate to get to the man, despite the circumstances. Joe, seemingly to come out of his trance, Joe proclaimed, "No, don't move." He ran towards the man, trying to stop him from pushing himself further. He couldn't bear to cause Trump any more pain. "Joe, where are you?" Trump asked hoarsely, still continuing to cling onto the wall. Joe, still running, realizing how severe Trump's condition was. Trump couldn't see Biden, yet he was always so willing to risk everything for him, and that only drove Biden further, and then Trump slipped. Desperate to save him, Joe reached for Trump's outreached hand. Pure passion was the only thing driving him forward. "Trump!" Just as he was about to grab onto Donald, new voices approached. He heard calls of Joe and Mr. Vice President. He knew his time would soon be up. Trump seemed to know the situation, removing his hand. Though he needed help, he knew Joe couldn't stay. "Go, Joe. You'll get caught," Trump cried, his eyes pleading for Joe to go. He didn't want to picture the situation Joe could be in if the security caught up with him. "Hurry," he added for good measure. Joe, refusing to leave Trump, stared down, not wanting to leave the man, but fearing for his political well-being. Trump felt that Joe was still there. He knew that there was only one reason he could, one thing that he could do. And as the tears began to stream down his face, he cried, the only thing that would convince Joe to leave. "Go," he cried, desperate for Biden to get out in time. Finally, understanding that Trump was giving it his all to get Joe out of there, Biden tucked tail and ran. As he fled from the security guards that began flooding the floor, he prayed that Trump would understand his feelings, that Trump had reciprocated them. Trump, still on the floor, reached for the nearest security guard, on his knees pleading. He begged for them not to go after him, not to let him go. Trump did all he could in his weakest position, hoping that Joe had gotten out in time. The two, though, heading in totally opposite directions, realized that they now had a connection. They now knew each other's feelings. Knew that despite the hurt that they both had caused, they loved each other. And that was enough to keep the small flame burning. Then.
Oh my gosh.
Hey guys, it's been a hot minute, but I finished the final chapter. He goes like, anyway, happy holidays.
We read that.
Yay. Wait a minute, I'll never forgive you for using a Metallica song for the title. Wait a minute, is for the bell, for whom the bells toll, a fucking Metallica song? Are you serious? Wait, hold on. There ain't no goddamn way. Is it actually a Metallica song? That'd be crazy if it was. And I feel like I would be the first to know. But anyway, what'd you think? Oh my god, it was a Metallica song. Oh my god. I liked rock music. Why did it have to be in here? Honestly, I'm very glad we fell through this weird-ass rabbit hole and whatnot. I like how this all started because we were like, what's crappy stories? And then we found out Joe Biden ex-Trump were Biden was pregnant, and we were like, yeah, this is what we're gonna read. This is the ship that we're gonna do. It was fantastic. Joline? Joline?
Huh?
Oh, I was... You were saying a thing, I thought you died.
Oh my god. I guess it cut out a minute.
Oh shit. But what'd you think? How was your
experience? That was something.
It sure was.
You know, why was it written really well?
Yeah.
Like, the characterization might not be like that, but like, why is the text kind of good?
Yeah. It's always crack ships that have the best writing sometimes.
Huh?
What?
No, I'm sorry. It cut out again, so I'm just...
I thought you were like, I thought you were like, excuse me? I thought you were about to be like, that is unfactual. I said sometimes crack ships have the best writing sometimes.
Ah. Oh my god, sorry, I just saw 11. I got so scared.
You saw what?
A lemon.
Oh, I thought you said 11, and I was like, the number 11's in your house right now?
Yes.
Oh, I thought you meant, when you said 11, I thought you meant the lemon tree. I was like, oh cool, you're growing another lemon.
Yeah.
Not a smut.
No. I wish there was another lemon on the tree.
Yeah. What fucking lemon did you just find?
It is Trump X Biden love story lemon. Lemon, weird emoji, eggplant, 18 plus, ongoing.
When is this ongoing? When's the last time it was updated?
Oh god, probably like 2020.
Yeah, that's even right.
A time of uncertainty and weird TikTok trends.
Yep. A time of sadness. Yeah, in 2020? Yeah, definitely sadness. Because everyone couldn't see no one.
That's sad. That's more my sadness. Ding, 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 ding. I showed you that, right?
I think so? You're gonna have to resend that to me because I don't remember off the top of my head.
It's my favorite thing. I think about it anytime that someone says something about sadness.
Wait, didn't you show me the fucking sans thing?
I did. I've shown you many things.
Yeah. And I've shown you many of things, including this.
You did.
Aren't you glad that the same person that we're going to be reading... Well, I guess not. It's not the same person. I mean, that person's the reason why we stumbled into this rabbit hole and read a fucking Donald Trump ex Joe Biden's.
You know, some things are just meant to happen. They're... It's part of our lore?
Is it our lore? Is it... Why? Why does it have to be part of our lore?
Look, it be like that sometimes.
Can't we just have normal lore?
What is normal lore? You mean boring lore?
Yeah. Yeah. Why be boring when you can be known for this?
You know. I don't know.
Yeah. I mean, thank you for joining me on this one, man. Thank you for reading.
It's a pleasure.
The political fan fiction.
We'll see what other cursed things we'll get to in the future.
We have a whole reading list to go through now.
Oh god. Every day I fear.
Every day we stray further from God. You think God stays in heaven because he's afraid about what he created? This is evident. This is proof.
Gosh.
But anyway, what are my lines? there's a
thank fucking, you.
There's a thing. Click on it and do that, and then do this.
And then the Discord.
Discord. All right, we got a Discord server. I got Twitter, Instagram, and that's it. And check out the playlists for other Wattpad videos. Hopefully, not a lot of them are cursed like this. We have generally normal ones, well, quote unquote normal. Depending on what you classify as normal, but either here or there.
Yeah.
But anyway, my name is Phoenix. That was Joline. And I guess we'll see you guys next time. Bye-bye.
Bye.